A breakthrough MIT study reveals that AI can replace nearly 12% of jobs already. Also, Trump just signed an executive order this week, the Genesis mission, which is designed to essentially centralize all of the AI data and supercomputers and power. Tons happening in AI right now. But before we get into these two big stories, I'm combining two stories today, which is something I don't typically do. But I just want to say it's Thanksgiving, and I'm very thankful for you. I'm thankful that you're here watching. I'm thankful that you're here engaging in the comments. And, you know, I'm just thankful that men like you are investing in yourselves, because it is very easy to get down on yourself. You don't get the thanks that you need. People will ask you for more and more and more. Your boss, your wives, your kids, everyone is always asking you for more. But you don't always get the thanks or the gratitude that you deserve. So I'm showing it to you right now. The fact that you're taking a few minutes out of your day to watch a video like this, to stay informed, to stay on top of the market, to understand what's coming down the pipeline for your job, coming for your ability to provide for your family, it's going to change dramatically. We all know that. The job you're doing now is not the same job you're going to be doing in 5 years. It's going to be completely different. But what I can say is that I'm going to show you the thanks and the gratitude that you deserve on this Thanksgiving, because you're investing in yourself, you're investing in your family. We need more. We need more of that. All right, boys, let's get to the first story here. The first story comes from, again, MIT. So this MIT story basically predicts that nearly 12% of the current U.S. workforce could be completely replaced with AI. And how did they come to this conclusion? Well, MIT used what they call the Iceberg Index to map roughly 151 million workers, 923 occupations, and 32,000 skills. And by the way, at the end of this segment, I'm gonna give you the top five careers that are displaceable right now, the top five careers. So if you're in one of those careers, you need to be thoughtful about your next steps. Anyway, what was their conclusion after assessing all these workers, occupations, and skills? Well, their conclusion was that AI tools are technically capable of performing tasks and replacing about 11.7% of US labor. Guys, this represents $1.2 trillion in wages. Those are wages that were going to guys like you and me, but now we're gonna be outsourced to software and AI. That is happening. By the way, I just don't understand where people come off saying that AI is not going to do this, that AI is not gonna displace jobs. Guys, if you look at history, every single revolution, whether it's the printing press or the combustion engine, it always leads to job displacement. What's different about AI though, what's different about AI is the scope and the speed with which it can happen. Example, self-driving cars become ubiquitous. It's proven that they're more safe. How many truckers are we gonna have on the roads if autonomous vehicles happen? How many taxi cabs? How many Ubers? They're all gone overnight. And it's like, you know, these types of technologies, that's one example, but you're gonna see, AI is just so fundamental in the way that it changes the way that everything operates. So anyway, big deal. I'll give you another example. We recorded a video on this. I'll post a link to it here, because one of the things that this MIT study has said is that this isn't gonna happen overnight. It's going to take time, but what is going to happen, mark my words, is companies are gonna start to figure it out. They're gonna start to figure it out. Oh, I actually don't need a customer service staff anymore. I have an AI robo calling staff that handles all my customer service inquiries. Once they figure it out, everyone is gonna follow suit. And then all of a sudden, you have a reduction of customer service staff by 90%. That is going to happen. And we covered this in a video a few weeks ago. I'll post a link to it here. Salesforce just fired 45% of their customer service staff because it's using AI, and they've been very happy with it so far. Klarna did something similar, but Salesforce did this. And again, if Salesforce figures this out, what's gonna happen? Every other company with a customer service engine is going to copy it. They're gonna copy and paste the model. That is happening. And gosh, guys, I don't know. 11.7%, that's table stakes. That is where we are at now. And AI right now, guys, is the worst it's ever going to be. It's only going to get better. It's not slowing down. And we're gonna talk about that in just a moment when we talk about Trump's Genesis project, which I think is very interesting. So we'll cover that in just a moment. But first, I wanna just cover the top five jobs that MIT said, these jobs, you don't need them anymore. You can use AI, fire everybody. They didn't necessarily say that, but that's kind of what the implication is. What are the top five jobs at risk? Office administration, HR, customer service, finance related jobs, and logistics. Gosh, I just, you know, it brings me back to college going to accounting class. I did not like accounting class. I'm a business marketing major. I did not like accounting class, but you know, there's people that are dedicating their entire lives to learning accounting. They're spending so much time and energy to learn accounting, but by the time they get their college degree, they're screwed. They're not gonna need accountants anymore because AI is gonna be doing 95% of it. So if there were 10,000 accounting jobs, now there will be 500 accounting jobs. And guess who's stuck holding the bag? By the way, I'm giving a quick shout out. I'm gonna put a link to a video here. I just covered this earlier this week. College graduates cannot find jobs, guys. College graduates cannot find jobs. Of the unemployed workforce, 25% of them are college graduates. Young people, college graduates cannot find jobs. The entire college system is completely broken. It is shot. I would even go as far as to say that college is a scam at this point. I don't know how else to say it. I'm not gonna go down that rabbit hole, but long story short, the skills that are being learned right now are being replaced. And we can see that in that list of HR, customer service, finance, logistics. These are all jobs, these are all careers that are built off the back of college. You gotta go to a college, university, gotta get your 4-year degree to get your foot in the door. I think that's changing, but regardless, I think that's very, very interesting. So what does this mean for us before we get into Genesis Project? Is be aware, start adapting now. Change is coming, change will continue to come at you. This is it. You gotta keep learning. You gotta keep learning. And this is not necessarily a new thing. However, now I think it's a more important thing because stuff is changing just obscenely rapidly, okay? You can do it though. Keep up with videos like this. Start using the AI in your work. Listen to podcasts, read research papers, talk to your bosses, talk to your colleagues, go to conferences. Just make sure you've got your thumb on the scale when it comes to AI in your organization. You don't wanna be left saying that AI is a scam. That's not gonna work out well for you when it comes to serving customers, clients, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, let's talk about the Trump's Genesis mission. And by the way, guys, I'm covering two topics today. Do you like me covering two topics? I felt like I had to cover two topics today, or do you think it's better just to stick to one? I just felt like I really wanna talk about the Genesis Project, but I also wanna talk about the MIT study. So anyway, if you like having two topics in one video, put it in the comments below. Maybe I'll actually record more videos, maybe, yeah. Anyway, let's look at Trump's Genesis mission. This was an executive order signed on November 24th in which Trump directed the U.S. Energy Department, more on that in a moment, and the U.S. National Laboratories to, quote, unite America's brightest minds and most powerful computers and vast scientific data into one cooperative system for research. So essentially, what we've got is a national integrated infrastructure for research, computing, data, and AI. So I actually think this is brilliant. I mean, we'll see what the execution is. But the reality is, like, we have all these massive infrastructure, tons of data, tons of resources, hundreds of billions, trillions of dollars going into various systems. Why not bridge them all together? Why not? Because I think it's actually very important that we do something like that, because we're competing on a global market right now, and we are in a race to AGI. We are in a race to AGI. Will we ever get there? I don't know, but we are in a race for it. You don't want to be the last one. It's like second is last when it comes to AGI. So it's very important that we are first. Now, I also want to point out that, you know, whenever you're looking at incorporating AI, you could have great prompts, but if you have bad data on the back end, if your first party data, if your third party data is not good, nothing else is going to work. You could be the best prompt engineer in the world, but if you're working with cruddy data, it doesn't matter. So this is, I think, another good reason why having this national federal infrastructure where you can have trusted data, surveys, quick communication between different departments, I think all of that is a win-win-win. I think all that makes a lot of sense. Michael Kratsis is the head of the White House Office of Science and Technology Policy, and he says that the goal here is to massively accelerate the rate of scientific breakthrough. I was watching a podcast the other day with Peter Diamantis from Abundance 365, or Abundance 360, And he had some tech guys on there, and they have this vision where they are able to build this AI, these AI supercomputers, this AI, almost like a god in a way, that it solves mathematics, it solves physics, it solves biology, it solves chemistry. This is the type of language they use, that it's solving these problems. It's like, you know, we've been working on all these problems for thousands of years, but AI is gonna come along and it's just gonna solve it immediately. We're not gonna have to worry about any of these problems anymore. It's gonna be abundance. Nobody's gonna have to work. Everything's gonna be free. They have this kind of utopian vision. I don't share that vision. Do you? Do you think that that's possible? I when I hear people talking like this, it's just kind of like, okay, it feels like they're selling me a dream. At any rate, it's just interesting. Now, I do think though that AI is gonna dramatically help us to come to scientific breakthroughs. I'll post a link to a video I recorded maybe a month or so ago, where AI was creating antibiotics, running millions and millions of tests almost instantly through scientific data and coming up with new antibiotics, which I thought was very interesting. I'll post a link to it here. I think that's very fascinating if you're interested in scientific breakthroughs. But how can we do that faster? How can we do that more rapidly? That is gonna be a big, big deal. What are the main goals here? Well, to accelerate scientific breakthroughs, solve math, chemistry, win the AI race against China, drive breakthroughs in critical areas. This is interesting. Energy, including fusion, advanced nuclear, modernizing the power grid, material science, biotechnology, quantum information, semiconductors, microelectronics. Now, what I also want to just mention here, or kind of double click on, is that this initiative is actually led by the U.S. Department of Energy. And I think, guys, this is really important. And it kind of starts to bring things full circle. What are big tech companies spending tens of billions of dollars on right now? Hundreds of billions of dollars. Where are big tech companies investing their money? Data centers, huge data centers. What used to be farmland are now grids in data centers. And what do data centers need? Energy. They need lots and lots and lots of energy. That's the key to this whole thing. That's the key to the whole thing. And what there, we've covered this in a few videos before. These large data centers come with problems. It could be everything from pollution to increased energy costs for residents nearby. People don't want them. We don't want them. It's a huge one being built in Indiana right now. I can't remember if it was Amazon building. I think Google's building a huge data center. It's going to use like 2.5 gigawatts of energy. But anyway, I don't quote me on that. I don't remember the exact stat. Regardless, what do we see here? We see huge amounts of data being that is needed. And in order to process that data, you need huge amounts of energy. And this, I think, is kind of the crux here. We are about to see a boom in construction and development of energy. Nuclear, fission, all these, new fiber lines, new power lines, it's all going to happen. There's gonna be a lot of opportunity for guys like you and me to make money, to learn new skills, because these companies, I mean, there's a lot of pressure not to bring in H-1Bs and not to bring people overseas. And even if they do, maybe you can learn new skills from them. The reality, guys, is this. This is a very interesting and important inflection time to learn new skills. And you might be saying, Mark, I'm old, I'm tired, I just wanna retire and lay on a beach. Guys, that's fine. But if you're saying, I wanna make a difference, I wanna stay relevant, I wanna be financially free, I plan on living until 90 years old, I got a family, I got kids, or I want them, you're gonna need to learn new skills. And I think that programs like this are gonna open up a lot of opportunities. Trades are obviously a good place to be, but I think that there's gonna be other types of jobs that are available that aren't gonna require you to do backbreaking work. And trust me, I've been there. I did HVAC work for a season of my life. It is very difficult. I tell you what, a lot of these wimps aren't gonna be able to put up with work like that. Regardless, there are gonna be a lot of opportunities. There's gonna be faster innovation. There's gonna be lower barriers for smaller players because we're gonna have shared infrastructure, tons of energy, shared data, great, high quality first party or third party data for you to use to inform your systems. That is all going to happen. You're gonna see tons of computing resources for startups and universities and smaller labs, the workforce development, we could see a boom. I think this is a time to be very grateful and thankful for the opportunities that are coming. Flip side, there are gonna be some problems, guys. There's data access and security problems. There's ethical and regulatory insights. I think back to that show, or that movie Enemy of the State with Will Smith, where there's just cameras are watching him from everywhere he goes. Guys, there's gonna be a lot of cameras over the next 10 years. Lots of cameras. Every single, you know, you see me walking down my neighborhood here, every single car in here has cameras. Every single home has Ring cameras. There are cameras everywhere. And when you're using AI in these huge databases to process all those cameras, I mean, you could be looking at a kind of surveillance state that would have made George Bush blush. Regardless, it's a wild time, guys. I think it's an exciting time. I'm very thankful for the opportunities. Things are gonna be different. Things are gonna be different, guys. I don't know what else to tell you. You're here, you understand it. If you like today's video, if you like the format, thanks. It was a little bit free-floating, I hit different topics, but I felt that I really wanted to touch on these. I think they're important. And if you enjoyed today's video, you will definitely like yesterday's video where we talk about AI in music. Musicians are completely cooked. Nobody's gonna be making money in music pretty soon. The number one Christian song on iTunes and Billboard is fully AI generated. The number one song, the number one album. You guys gotta check it out. Check out this video. It's short, it's quick, you'll appreciate it. I'll see you there, boys. Peace, happy Thanksgiving.